Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today I thought we would take a look at the Too Tall Toby YouTube channel at the 3D modeling practice playlist, and we would try to do this coat hanger. So let's give this one a try in Onshape and see if we can come up with the correct masks.
Ow!
So like I said, this challenge comes from the Too Tall Toby YouTube channel, and I will include a link to this challenge down in the description of this video in case you want to take the challenge yourself. But at this point, I'm going to click play on that video so the clock starts and we can see how long it takes us to construct this coat hanger in Onshape. So whenever I'm looking at a challenge like this, I start out by taking a look at the title block. I can see the material and the material density. That's going to be very important if our goal is to calculate the mass of this thing. I'm also going to take a look at just kind of the overall design, and I see that the entire coat hanger is 6 millimeters in wall thickness. And I can see that the majority of the dimensions are being shown here on the front view. So we've got this kind of tangent to tangent length of 430. We've got this radius 21, the overall height here of 235, et cetera, et cetera. Now, one thing about this design that's a little bit tricky is that this radius here, radius 21, is on the outside of the model. So you can see that's like on the outside of that arc. But then as we come up here, the direction of these arcs change, and now we're here on the inside of the coat hanger, but this radius 19 is now on the opposite edge of the model. And that's gonna be a little bit tricky to calculate, but fortunately we've got a little hint in this drawing up top here that says hint, use offset sketch entities. So I'm definitely gonna take advantage of that hint, and I'm gonna try to offset some sketch geometry to help me during my layout process. The other thing that's a little tricky is that a lot of times if you try to create a sweep that intersects with itself all in one command, you're gonna run into problems and the modeler is going to fail. And so we wanna come up with a solution. We'll probably just stop the sweep short a little bit and then do a second feature that extrudes up to next. So let's get into Onshape and see how this is done. I'm gonna start out here in Onshape and choose to create a new document. I'll call this thing 06-08B coat hanger, and we will create this document. We're gonna go to our front plane and begin our first sketch. Let's get normal 2 here. And let's jump into a line command and create a line that comes across here horizontal. And then let's make an arc on that line, and then a tangent line coming off of that arc. And let's do the same thing over here on this side, an arc coming off of this line and then a tangent arc coming off of that. This way we can get some basic dimensions in and make sure we're at least in the ballpark of the correct proportional size. So this one's supposed to be 21, this one is supposed to be 21, and the distance between those arcs at tangent is supposed to be 430 millimeters. All right, so far so good. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create the geometry that comes up from here. So we go into another tangent arc. This one's at 19 millimeters, and then a vertical line, and then another tangent arc that comes over for the coat hanger part of things. And then we're gonna do what's called a spherical, it's really just a revolve of an arc, a spherical revolve. And so now at this point, we are kind of getting ourselves to the point where we're gonna need some additional information, because this dimension here is not 19. The 19 is actually to the inside. So I think that at this point, what I'm going to do is an offset entities. So I'll do an offset here. Let's see if we can do a select, let's do a right mouse button here, select tangent connected edges. Yes. There we go, that is what I wanted there. And that's gonna be offset in this direction, and then that offset distance is going to be 6. And so let's make sure that we have that at 6. Yes, we do. And then let's add a dimension here. So this dimension is gonna be from the base up to the very top there at a total of 235. This dimension here is gonna be a radius of 19. This dimension here on the outside is going to be a radius of 27. Very helpful to have that offset geometry there waiting for me. And I think that the location of this hanger doesn't really matter as long as this point here is locked down somewhere. So I'm just going to lock down that point, and then I'll finish up here by adding in these angle dimensions. So we've got an angle dimension here of 26 and an angle dimension here of 25. And I think that should get me pretty close to having this thing fully constrained, Maybe one more dimension here for the straight section, 55. There we go. Everything went black. That's what we want. We'll take these two points here and make sure that they are horizontal. And finally, for this final location here for our sweep, it really doesn't matter where we put it. I think we just need to set it up so that it doesn't come all the way out to the end. If we were to have this come all the way out to the end, let's say, for example, we connect these two, we can kind of see what's going to end up happening if we do that. So let's just do it, and then we'll, if it doesn't work, we can always change that relationship and come back in and fix it up. So that's all of our dimensions from that front view. That's using that little trick of offsetting the geometry by 6 millimeters. I think this looks pretty good. Let's exit this sketch and let's create a new sketch plane. So we go in here to our sketch planes, and this is going to be a sketch plane which is going to be parallel to the top plane and coincident to this point here. And so we hit the green check mark, and now we're going to select this plane, begin a new sketch, and sketch a circle with a diameter of 6 millimeters. And then we're going to make that circle coincident to this point here. And we're going to make this point and this point horizontal to one another. And that looks pretty good for our sweep profile. Let's exit that sketch as well. And now let's jump into the sweep command and choose to sweep this profile along. Let's go to our sweep path. This path here. So once again, I'm going to right mouse button, select, and I'm going to say tangent connected edges. And it does wrap all the way around, but it kind of stops here or shows red. It shows it's going to be a problem. Let's unselect this last line here. Look at that. Now everything looks like it is completing correctly. We select this last line again and everything goes red. So I think we're just running into a problem there where the sweep is intersecting with itself. Let me edit this sketch. Let me get rid of this coincident relationship and just back this off a bit. And we will hit the green check mark, and there we go. That's what we were hoping for. Now we can pick this face here, and we can choose to extrude right from that face, and that extrude is going to go up to next. Boom! That is beautiful. That thing is looking good. So now the final thing we need to do is just add in this this final section here, this 2 millimeter brace. Here we can see this 2 millimeter brace. Here we can see this is coming up from the bottom of the part at 110. So I think we can do this with a rib just directly on the front plane. So front plane, begin a sketch. Let's get normal 2 here. Let's just sketch a line kind of out in space and then give that line a dimension from the very bottom of the part. Can even do it from this bottom plane here to there. That's going to be at 110, and let's just make sure that that is kind of inside of the hanger. All right, looking good. And let's exit that sketch and jump into the rib command, and we'll pick on that face there. This is going to be at 2 millimeters, and I think we just want it to go the other direction. Yep, that's what we want. And then with the rib command, what we want to remember is that we can use this option here, extend profiles to part. And that extends that rib out and gives us the perfect geometry for this thing. Man, this thing is looking good. Oh, I missed one single feature. I missed our spherical revolve. Just saw it. I was about to celebrate, but then I realized that I missed our spherical revolve. So let's go to the front plane. Let's begin a sketch here on the front plane. Let's get normal 2, and let's take, we can just take this edge here and convert it, really. Do a convert entities there, and we're going to create another line that comes down from there from the midpoint, and then we are going to jump into a 3-point arc, and we want to make sure that the center of that arc is coincident to this point here. And that should give us what we need for our revolve. So the revolve is going to be this region here, and the revolve axis is going to be this line here. There we go. That gives us our spherical revolve. And now we're ready to celebrate because this geometry looks amazing. I'm going to do a right mouse button here on the name of the part and say assign material. And I'm going to go into the custom material library that I created in an earlier video. And I'm going to assign the material of plain carbon steel. We can hit the green check mark and we can finish up down here in the corner by clicking mass properties. And the mass of this part is 254 grams. So let's go back to the YouTube video here. Let's stop the clock, 8 minutes and 40 seconds. And now let's take the YouTube video and we'll go all the way to the end where the correct answer will be shown. And the correct answer is 254 grams. So we did it. We did it right. We can go down here. We can add a comment. We can say, I did it in 8 minutes and 40 seconds using Onshape. Awesome challenge. And we can say comment, and now everyone will see that we were able to do that in just 8 minutes and 40 seconds using Onshape. So I hope that you guys enjoyed that tutorial. I hope that you learned a little bit. If you did, let me know down in the comments what you learned. If you saw me doing anything that I could be doing a little more efficiently, let me know that down in the comments as well. And of course, if you're enjoying this series, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next episode.